अस्सलाम वालेकुम, दिस इज़ दुआ शाकिर। माई रोल नंबर इज़ EP 177-00-30। आई एम फ्राम फोर्थ प्रोफेशनल इवनिंग एंड टुडे आई एम गोना बी टॉकिंग अबाउट एंटी इंफ्लेमेटरी इफेक्ट्स एंड वॉन्ट फ्रे मैथड। लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द बेसिक। एंटी इंफ्लेमेटरी इफेक्ट इज़ द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस और ट्रीटमेंट डेट रिड्यूसेज इन्फ्लेमेशन और स्वेलिंग। Let's move towards the mechanism of action. So, as being a pharmacist, we all know that the basic mechanism of action of the anti-inflammatory drugs are the inhibition of the cyclooxygenase enzyme. And we know that there are two types of the COX cyclooxygenase, that is 1 and 2. COX 1 is expressed in the body, maintains the mucosal lining, kidney function, platelet aggregation. Although COX 2 is not expressed in the body but expresses itself during inflammatory response. Introduction. There is a definition of a pain. According to the International Association for the Study of Pain, IASP, what does it say? Let's see. Pain is an unpleasant sensory and emotional experience associated with actual or potential tissue damage or described in terms of such damage. Pain studies are very difficult to perform and they are subjective and very limited to ethical moral values. So usually animals are used, most probably mice and rats. Nociception. Nociception refers to a signal arriving at the CNS as a result of a stimulation of specialized sensory receptors in the peripheral nervous system called nociceptors. So in short, I can say that the nociception is a kind of a physiological definition of a pain. Let's move further. Nociception in animals, replacement, refinement, reduction. So these three R's, which are in relation to science, are the guiding principle for more ethical use of animal testing. Replacement refers to the methods that replace or avoid the use of animals at all cost. Example include the use of the alternative methods, for example, computer modeling or in vitro methods. Refinement. Refinement refers to the improved or the optimized methods where the use of the animals are unavoidable. So in this case, this includes the training of animals to cooperate with certain procedures, example blood sampling, to reduce the stress or anxiety in animals. Reduction. As the name suggests, it refers to the methods to minimize the animal use for the research purposes. Such methods include appropriate experimental design, sample size determination, statistical analysis, and the use of advanced non-invasive imaging techniques. Behavioral methods to measure pain-like behaviors. The behavior method used to measure the nociception in rodents can be divided into stimulus evoked and non-stimulus evoked. Stimulus evoked can further be divided into pain induced by mechanical stimuli, by heat stimuli, and cold stimuli. I'll be further talking about the mechanical stimuli. But first, I'll be talking about the two terms, allodynia and hyperalgesia. Allodynia is a condition in which pain is caused by a stimulus that does not normally elicit pain. For example, bad sunburn can cause temporary allodynia, and touching that sunburned skin or running cold or warm water over it can be very painful. Hyperalgesia is an abnormally increased sensitivity to the pain, which may cause by damage to nociceptors or peripheral nerves and can cause hypersensitivity in the stimulus. So I can say that exaggerated pain response come under the hyperalgesia. So the basic difference between the allodynia and hyperalgesia is, in allodynia, the stimulus not actually causes the pain, but in the circumstance of allodynia, it causes pain. And in hyperalgesia, the stimulus actually causes the pain. I'll be further talking about the mechanical stimuli. So under the heading of the mechanical stimuli, von Frey method comes, and von Frey test method was developed by the physiologist Maximilian von Frey. It is a method of evaluating mechanical allodynia in mice or rats. What happened in this test? Let's see. So animals are placed individually in small cages with a mesh or otherwise penetrable bottom. A monofilament is applied perpendicularly to the plantar surface of the hind paw until it buckles, delivering a constant predetermined force. What is a monofilament? It is a calibrated plastic filament hair applied to the surface of paw. It requires a force to induce. A response is considered positive if the animal exhibits any nocivensive behavior, including a brisk paw withdrawal, licking or shaking of the paw, either during the application of the stimulus or immediately after the filament is removed. Why the plantar surface of the hind paw is most commonly used area for testing, other areas of the body, including the dorsal surface of the hind paw or the abdomen, can also be used. As you can see in the given picture, that a filament is penetrated through the space between the cage and it is applied until animal shows the response. Different methods or approaches are used to determine the mechanical activity, mechanical sensitivity using manual Von Frey, including up and down method, ascending stimulus, percentage response or percent response. Let's discuss about the up and down Von Frey method. So up and down Von Frey method is basically used to determine the mechanical force required to induce a paw withdrawal or the removal of a paw response in 50% of the animals. In the experiment, the filament is applied with the force to cause close to the 50% withdrawal threshold. If there is no response, the next filament with the higher force is tested because our subject in the first place didn't show any response. And in the case if there is a response, the next lower force of filament is tested or applied. At least 6 responses of estimated threshold are required for optimal calculation of 50% threshold. A disadvantage of this method is that the number of the measurement per animal is variable and that it requires repeated time-intensive measurements which may lead to sensitization or learned responses. Next method is ascending stimulus method. It provides the estimate of mechanical withdrawal threshold, but in this particular method, Von Frey filaments can only be applied in discrete form and not continuously like electronic Von Frey method, which I'll be discussing in later slides. The basis of this method is the application of monofilament with increased force until a withdrawal response is observed. And the Von Frey filament that causes the positive response, that is a withdrawal, is designated as mechanical withdrawal threshold. An advantage of this method is that it avoids the excessive application of Von Frey filaments that elicit aversive behaviors. Let's further talk about the percentage response. So the last method of the manual Von Frey is the percent response. In this method, Von Frey filament of the varying different forces are applied in the ascending order. Max 5 to 10 applications are done. Either we get a response or not. The number of the positive responses to each filament is converted to a percent response. The advantage of this approach is that each animal receives the same number and type of a stimuli, although the number of the tests per hind paw could exceed 50. Let's talk about the electronic Von Frey method, which would be the second method of the manual Von Frey method. First was the manual Von Frey method and second was the electronic Von Frey method. So it operates under the same basis of the Von Frey principles, except that a single unbending filament is applied with the increased force until a paw withdrawal response is elicited. As you can see in the picture in the bottom, that the filament is applied through a device and is not applied manually. The main advantage of this process is obviously the automation, the device that is being used. There it is less of the errors and it is automated. And further, it can be compared to the manual Von Frey, and increasing force is applied to a single filament. Methods available for electronic Von Frey are the dynamic plantar acesiometer and mouse mat or the red mat. Let's talk about the dynamic plantar acesiometer. It is a proper instrument with a mesh screen floor under which movable stimulator unit is placed. The apparatus applies a Von Frey 0.5 micrometer of the filament to the plantar surface and then increasing the force until the withdrawal threshold is reached. The device automatically records the force of which paw withdrawal occurs and the rate at which the force is applied can be changed. As you can see in the picture, this is known as a dynamic plantar cystometer. There is a perforated platform, controller, animal enclosure cage, base, and a stimulation unit. The last but not the least is the MouseMed or the RedMed electronic warfarin method. Let's discuss what does it say. So it is the only warfarin system with the force range intended for mice. The rotary force transducer has a major range of 0.1 grams to the 7 grams of force. This system has been extensively validated and makes a considerable contribution in 3 hours. A soft transducer ensures minimal vibration and reduces touch-on responses. Both instruments have been validated against manual warfarin filaments and found to produce less variable data in addition to being easier to use. As you can see in the picture, this is the MouseMed or the RedMed electronic warfarin method, and you can see that the transducer is attached to the rat and waiting for the elicited response. These are the references from where I collected my information, and thank you so much for giving me your time and listening to my slides, and thank you so much for giving this platform to show and express ourselves. So thank you so much, and Allah Hafiz.